Are you tired of losing files or struggling to find all your documents? Well, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you everything you need to know about Google Drive so you can stay organized and easily access your files anytime, anywhere. And be sure to watch to the end where I have some bonus tips so you can get the most out of your cloud storage. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. So to begin, let's make sure that we are familiar with the left-hand side menu. Now we're going to come back to this new button because of course that's essential when it comes to uploading or creating a new file, but let's get familiar with the other areas here on the left-hand side. First, we have our home screen, and that's what we're viewing right here at the moment. We've got a nice big search bar here at the top so we can start searching in the files that we're looking for, but down below there's a combination of two areas, suggested folders and suggested files. Now, remember, this is not necessarily the files that you last touched or that you last edited. Neither is the same for folders. But Google Drive is going to try and assess your recent behavior and suggest helpful folders or files that you want to access. And you can see here under the suggested files, there's a complete reason suggested column saying that, well, I edited this last week, I opened this not too long ago. So things that I've either uploaded or opened or edited recently are probably going to show up here. This might be helpful for some, but not necessarily for everyone, so I don't want you to worry too much about the home screen. Now, the My Drive area is where most of the action takes place, and this is how My Drive looks at the moment. I've got a couple of folders here at the beginning. Now, these are full of other folders and other files, but those things that do not exist within a folder also will appear here within my My Drive screen as well. Now you'll notice as I open up this folder, and then I'm going to open up another folder, at the top of the screen, you will see some breadcrumbs. So here I'm within my big file folder, but I can easily go back to my personal folder here or go all the way back to My Drive. So that makes it nice and convenient. But there's also another way in which we can view our files, and that's by coming back to the menu and selecting this little arrow, which is going to break out our folders. Now, it's not going to break out our individual files, but just like you may be used to with your File Explorer on Windows, this will break out your folders and you can continue to branch out those folders here on the left-hand side. So if you prefer to navigate this way, you can do that here by expanding or minimizing the My Drive option here. Now, the third one down here is listed as computers. Now, you may not see this on your account because I have mine set up for Drive for Desktop. We're not going to go into those details within this video, but if you'd like to learn more, I'll leave a link in the description down below. The fourth one is the Shared with Me option, and this is going to show all of the files that others have shared with you. So here you can see the email addresses of other people or other accounts which have shared files with me. It doesn't mean that we can't place these in other areas of our account, and I'm going to show you how to do that, but if you've had someone share a file or a folder with you, this is probably the quickest and easiest way to find those files. Below that, we have our recent files, which is going to quickly sort everything within our Drive account by what we have touched or edited most recently. Now, below recent, we have our starred files, which I actually don't have any at the moment right now. This is for files and or folders that you use most frequently and you want to access right away. I'm going to show you more details on that in just a moment. Now, the spam area is something that is hopefully empty for you as well, but this is a convenient way and a secure way for Google Drive to remove things that people have maybe shared with you, but they're not sure if they should be sharing with you. Remember, if someone has your email address, technically they could share a file with you within your Google Drive, but we don't want to have it appear anywhere else. And anything that remains in here for more than 30 days will be emptied as well. So if someone says that they've shared something with you and you still can't find it, this is a good place to go looking within that spam folder. Below spam, we have our trash. These are things that are sent to be deleted permanently. Now, when you take a file and you select that trash icon, it's going to come here first, just in case you may want to revive it or come back to it later. But items that have remained in the trash will be deleted forever after 30 days. And if you don't want to wait that long, you can come up here and select empty that trash. But this is a nice safeguard, very similar to the trash feature within Gmail, where things will remain for 30 days before being permanently deleted. Last but not least, we have our storage space, which is going to show you the size of all of our largest files. It's going to sort everything from largest to smallest, just in case we get crouching over that limit. And yes, in many cases, it's your Google Drive account, which is going to count the most to your total storage limit. So now that you're familiar with Google Drive's navigation, let's get to the bread and butter of Google Drive, and that is adding new files or creating new files or folders right here within Google Drive. Here in the top left-hand corner, we will always have access to this new button. And if I select this, I can either choose to upload a new file, I can upload an entire new folder, or I can create a new folder here as well. But perhaps the easiest way to add a new file or folder is to simply drag it into your Drive account. So if I open up my folder here within my computer, I'm going to grab this image, and you can see if I drag it down here, the color changes. I'm going to release it, and now that file is going to show up here within my Google Drive. Now, because I did this here within my home screen, it hasn't placed it in any specific folder. If I was to go into my Drive and go into personal, and if I was to drag a file here or select new, it is always going to add it to the folder or the area in which I am viewing. So that can be very handy, very convenient. So if I'm adding things within a particular area, I can just continue to add to this particular space. And of course, if I don't want to drag and drop, I can simply select new, select file upload. This will automatically open up my dialog window, and then I can select an image, a document, really any type of file that I would like to upload to this particular space. The other option you will see here when selecting the new button is that we can create a new Google Doc, a new Google Sheet, or a number of other Google formats. Now, we're not going to get into the details of creating each and every one of these types of documents. Just note that any type of Google file format that you create here will automatically be saved to your Drive account. Next up, let's talk a little bit about organizing our files and folders. So once again, if we come here to the new button, you can see that the very first option here is to create a new folder. Now, because I'm already within my personal folder, if I select new and new folder, it's going to automatically add this folder here. So first we'll need to give this folder a name. I'm going to call this one my tax documents. So I'm going to say create, and then that folder is going to be created here within personal. Now, if I've mistakenly added this folder in the wrong location, no problem. I can simply click on it, and then once it's selected, I can choose to move this to another location. So this is going to show me some of my most recent folders here, or I can click all locations and dive deeper into other places within my Drive account. So don't worry if you've created your folder in the wrong place. Now, when it comes to adding files to a folder, of course, we can do that here within our folder. But if I go back, don't forget that we can simply drag and drop. So maybe this new message I want in that tax documents folder, I'm going to drag it and release it. It's going to put it in that folder. I'm going to do the same thing here with this particular form. I'm going to drag and drop it. And now when I open up this folder, that's where those two files will reside. But let's don't stop at just giving our folders a clear name, because there's a few other tools that are available to us so that we can make our folders stand out. One of my favorites is to actually change the color of the folder. You'll see that by default, each of our new folders will have this dark gray color. But if we right click on any folder and come down here to organize, not only do we have the option to move that folder or to add a star, we can change the color. So maybe since these are tax documents, I want to change this to the color green. Now that's going to stand out a little bit more than my regular shade here for my big file folder. But I'm going to go one step further. I'm going to come back down to organize and I'm going to say add to starred. Not only will there be a little star here beside it, but if I come back to my menu and select starred, now that folder will remain, because maybe this start area is where I want to access my most recent or my most actively used files and folders, at least the things that I'm working on in the short term. I can access them here. And when I no longer need them, I can simply come back to organize and remove that star. It hasn't removed the folder, it's just removed it from this particular location. And of course, when it comes to keeping our files and folders organized, don't forget to make use of the search bar here at the top of the screen. Now, if I was looking for that tax folder, just typing in the word tax is obviously going to bring that up, but it's also going to bring up other related files and folders. And you'll notice when it comes to some of the other things here as well, even though tax is not in the name, it is going to be searching through those documents as well. And yes, this is a JPEG, meaning that it has found the word tax within that image, and it's found the word tax within this PDF as well. So the power of Google search is also at your fingertips right here within Google Drive. You can also, of course, filter your files or folders by type. So maybe you only want to be looking at your folders. Well, you can do that here as well. It's only going to bring back your folders. You can continue to filter by when was a file last modified, who you've maybe shared a file with before, who has shared that file with you as well. A number of different ways in which you can quickly filter when you're looking for a particular file. Next, let's take a look at one of the most used features here within Google Drive, and that is sharing files or folders with others. To share a file within Drive, simply right-click on that file or folder and then come up to the share option. Now, you may see two options, share and copy link. In most cases, we want to ignore the copy link because this is going to make this file public, meaning that you can share this link and others will be able to continue to share that link with anyone else. That's why we want to select the share option, which is going to give us this dialog here. And where the cursor is waiting, we can add people, groups, and even calendar events if we want to share a file with a group of people who have been invited to a particular meeting. In this case, I'm going to go and select someone here from my contacts, and to the right, we are given a drop-down menu. Now, by default, it's going to give them editor access, meaning that they can edit anything within this document, including the ability to share with others. Well, depending on that particular file, you may want to change that to one of the other two options. We can make them a viewer, meaning that they can only see this particular document and not make any changes, or we can also make them a commenter, which of course will allow them to see it, but they won't be able to edit. They'll only be able to add notes or add suggestions within that particular file. So you'll need to choose which of these three permission levels is most appropriate for the file that you're sharing. And then down below, we have an option to notify people and include a message. So by default, this will be checked, meaning that they will receive an email notification that we have shared this file with them. I recommend that you leave this on in almost all cases so that they know that you've shared something with them. If we uncheck this, you'll notice that the message box down below will disappear. This is our opportunity to add a quick message or maybe a few other details. You're not required to add a message here if the notify people is on, but it is an optional one. At this point, we can select send, and now that file will be shared with that particular individual. Now, of course, over time, as you start sharing files and folders with others, you may forget who you've shared those files with. Well, once again, if I come to this file and if I come to share and select share, it's going to show me all of the people that have access. And here is now that other individual that has access to this file. It will also tell me what their permission level is. And if I want, I can come over here and change that. Maybe I want to change it to a viewer. If I want, maybe I want to remove access altogether. I can even choose to transfer ownership from myself to them as well. So here is where you can always go back and review who you have shared this information with. So now that you're comfortable with Google Drive basics, both navigating around Drive, uploading your files, and sharing both files and folders, let's take a look at a few quick bonus tips so that you can get the most out of your experience. The first one is the ability to manage version history, and this is especially helpful if you're wanting to manage edits or keep prior versions without simply adding further files. So for example, here if I want to take a look at this particular file, Post Community Samples, I'm going to right-click on it, and below Organize, you can see that there's an option called File Information. And within this menu, we have an option called Manage Versions. If I select this option here, it's going to show me that there's actually two versions of this same file. They were uploaded at the same day, almost at the same time, but there must be some slight different version between the two. That's okay. I haven't cluttered up my drive with multiple files. It's only going to be listed as a single file, but I actually have access to both versions. Here is version one, and here is the current version here. And what's great about this is that instead of uploading a brand new file, I can choose to upload a new version of this document. Next, there are two settings that often Google Drive users forget, but can be very, very helpful. If we come up here to the right-hand screen and select the gear icon and then select settings, we want to scroll down and take a look at both our uploads options and our offline options. The first one here allows us to convert uploads to Google Docs editor format automatically. What this means is that if we check this checkbox, if I was to upload a text document or something like a Microsoft Word document, it would automatically upload a Google Doc version. So we can start editing it right away here within Google Drive. Now, you don't have to make this selection, but if you are wanting to continue to edit and automatically make those conversions at the time of upload, you may want to select this option here. And then below that, we have the option to access our Google Docs, Sheets, and Slide files offline. That's right, even if we don't have internet access. So I would recommend checking this box as long as you are not on a public or a shared computer. This will allow you to both create, open, and edit your recent files even if you don't have an internet connection. So this can be great for people who do a lot of their work on a laptop, for example, and even if you're on a flight without internet access or somewhere else while traveling, you'll have access to your Google files. So now you know how to upload, organize, and share files right here within Google Drive. And if you still have questions, be sure to let me know in the comments down below. And if you're looking for even more ways to get the most out of your Google apps and tools, be sure to watch one of these videos next. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.